Hello friends, in this video we are going to see how to run a wordcount program by using an input file in Hadoop. So in my case I am using virtual machine and I have already installed Hadoop on my machine. So we can check it with the help of this command JPS, that is Java process status. So you can see all the nodes are visible here. That means Hadoop is properly installed and properly running. So if you want to know how to run or how to install Hadoop on your machine, you can refer to the link which is given in the description, where I have shown how to install Hadoop step by step. So to proceed with, we will see how to run a wordcount program. So what I have done is I have prepared an input file. So this is the input file which I am going to pass as input to the wordcount program in Hadoop. So you can see there are number of words which are repeated. For example, MapReduce word, it is repeated many number of times. You can check it here. So like this, what our wordcount program is going to do is, wordcount program is going to count the word, each and every word, as many times it has occurred in this particular file. So to do that, what we will do is, we will put that input file onto Hadoop distributed file system. So that file is in the downloads folder, and currently I am in this folder. If I check with pwd command, I am in this folder where my Hadoop is installed. So what I will do is, I will put that file onto hdfs. So to do that, I will run this command, hdfs dfs hyphen put. I want to put input file onto hdfs, but that input file is in the downloads folder. So I will go to that path. So okay, it is times back. Okay, downloads folder. So that input file is here. This is the path of the input file on my local system. So this dot dot means what? This dot dot means one step back. So I have gone one step back, and in downloads folder I have that input file. So I want to put that input file onto Hadoop distributed file system. So this is a slash, which is actually a directory, starting directory of Hadoop distributed file system. So that's why this is the command. So just press enter. So I can check whether my file is there onto hdfs or not. So for that, the command is hdfs dfs. So I will run a different command, that is ls, and I will ls into the root directory, that is the starting directory of Hadoop distributed file system. So just press enter. So it will show me all the files and directories which are present on the Hadoop distributed file system. So the name of my file was input. So see here, you can check. So our file is successfully put on Hadoop distributed file system now. Okay, if you want to check, you can check with the help of user interface also. So we will go to the web UI of Hadoop. As it is Hadoop version 3, so that's why the port number is 9870. For Hadoop version 2, it is 50070. So if I go to here and browse the file system, I can see that input file here also. So see here, you can check, hit the first 32 kilobytes and you will see the same content here. Okay, so we have successfully put our file onto hdfs file system. Now what to do is, to run that wordcount, to run the wordcount program by using that input file, we will type this command. So I am already in Hadoop folder, so I know that there is bin folder inside that. So I will use that bin folder and file with the name Hadoop. So dot slash bin Hadoop jar share. So whatever I am typing, it is just a path. MapReduce, Hadoop MapReduce examples dot jar. So in out of those examples, I want to run wordcount program. So it is by default present in Hadoop. And to this wordcount program, I want to pass that input file as an input, and for this input file I want output. So I will write down input underscore output. So my output will be present in the directory named as input underscore output. So once I press enter, you will see mapping and reduction. So mapping will be done first and then reduction will start, because we have only single input file. So if you can check, it is showing running the job with some job ID. So it will show us map and reduction. So see, map 0% and reduce 0%. So first of all, mapping will be done, and then reduction will start for that single file. So you can check, mapping is 100% and now reduction will also start. Once it is done, we can check the input file. So it is done. So what we can do is, if you want to check the output, we can check it in the terminal also, or we can go to the user interface web UI and just refresh here. So see, this is the folder you can see, input underscore output. So in this par dash r dash 5 times zeros, this is the file, and hit it, you will see the output. See all the words and their counts you can see here. So this is the one way how you can check your output. If you want to go to terminal and check the output, we can run the command hdfs dfs hyphen cat. So my input, my output is present in this file, in this folder. So hyphen cat input underscore output slash the name of the file in which the output was is this part dash r dash 1 2 3 4 5 times zero. So how, from where I got the information? Because I have seen the same name in web UI of Hadoop. So if I cat it and if I press enter, I will see the output here. So see, for that input file, this is the output. This is showing us the word count. So you can check, map reduce word has come 4 number of times, and the count of other words it has also shown you. So this is how you can run your word count program in Hadoop by using simple commands. So that's it from my side. Thank you very much.